Hey guys, Josiah here with Aesthetyx Fitness. In today's video, I'm going to go over the 4 best shoulder exercises that you are not doing. All right, so as you know, shoulders are one of the most crucial components of an aesthetic physique. You are never going to see someone with a really well-built physique that has lagging shoulders. So it's really important to make sure you're hitting them well and also making sure that you're sparing them from injury, hitting them in ways that are going to train them functionally and help injury-proof them so that you can continue training them through the rest of your life. So with that in mind, I want to share these 4 shoulder exercises with you because I've used them for the last couple years. I love all of them and I have seen some really great improvement in my shoulder development from using them. So I'm going to share them with you here, show them to you, and explain why I think they are the 4 best shoulder exercises that you should be doing.
First up is the lateral delt raise. The key with this exercise is to perform it with a light enough weight that you can perform the entire motion in a slow and controlled manner to avoid cheating using momentum or your traps. In order to further take the traps out of the equation, ensure that your shoulders stay down throughout the entire range of motion so that you're not accidentally shrugging the weight up. Furthermore, you can use a partial rep range, as you see me doing here, where I've segmented the exercise into thirds in order to ensure that you're placing optimal stress on the lateral deltoid all the way through the range of motion. Next up, we have the Bradford press, which is an excellent exercise for shoulder mobility. The key with this motion is, since you are pressing the weight behind your neck, you want to ensure that you are not extending your arms to their full length. As you see, I stopped just above my head. The reason for this is that if I were to extend my arms all the way upward, I'd be placing my shoulders at great risk for impingement. So by avoiding this, it keeps your shoulders safe and helps make the motion more effective. Third is the modified Cuban press. Now, the original Cuban press exercise starts off with an upright row motion. Now, this unfortunately, again, puts your shoulders at risk for shoulder impingement due to the angle. So by modifying the original angle of ascent to a side lateral raise, which then rotates and presses upwards, you avoid this risk for impingement while still maintaining the beneficial rotator cuff strengthening and even deltoid development that the original exercise has. It's also very important, as you see, to perform each segment of the exercise as a separate motion. Don't try to cheat it all together, or again, you risk harming your shoulders. Last but definitely not least is the angled rear delt fly. You'll see a lot of people performing this motion at 90 degrees to their body, but by moving it into a 45 degree angle and bringing your elbows behind your body, you take advantage of the other function of the rear deltoid, which is to extend your arms behind your body. By doing it this way, it'll allow you to feel the rear deltoid a lot better and work it harder.
All right, guys, that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Of course, if you enjoyed the video, leave a like down below and subscribe to this channel because I've got new content coming out all the time for you. And leave a comment down below letting me know what you think of these 4 shoulder exercises and any questions that I might be able to answer so that I can help you train smarter and look better.